Now in this exercise we will again fill in the blanks with the suitable adverbs, okay, and we have to specify the state of their kind also, means what kind of adverb is it, that also we have to mention in the bracket. So first example is given to you. She left yesterday for her new home in Bangalore. So blank in blank we have written yesterday. So yesterday shows the time, okay, and as it modifies the verb left, it is called adverb. And as this adverb is, you know, telling about the time, this adverb is called adverb of time. So the same way as we have learnt, we have to use them now here as per the sentence. Your answer may be vary, no problem, but it should be meaningful. So we are waiting for him. So we can write any, like let's say we are waiting for him eagerly. Okay, so how you are waiting, so eagerly, so that means it has answered how, and that's why it is adverb of manner. He told us dash not to walk on the grass, so we can say he told us strictly not to walk on the grass. So again here strictly in the blank and adverb of manner in the bracket. Then I'm not strong, we can say enough to help him carry out that box. Okay, so here enough shows the degree, that at what degree you are not strong, okay, to help him carry out. So we can say that as it shows the extent, at what extent you are strong, so it is used for like it is the adverb of degree. Okay, and then she will dash be happy in that job, so we can say she will certainly be happy. And when we are just telling it in a very assertive way, we can say that it is the adverb of affirmation. And when you are, you know, just using any denial, so we can say that is the adverb of negation. So here when we are using certainly, so it is called the adverb of affirmation. Then dash I saw him walking to the church, so here we can use any time. Okay, so let's say yesterday or last Sunday I saw him walking to the church. So as yesterday this word shows the time, it is called adverb of time. Then why? So now we will see this seventh one. My father is dash late for work, so you can write any word related to vocabulary, okay, sometimes or never, usually, anything, again. So they all are called the adverb of frequency. So you will write here those words which you want to, and into bracket you will write the adverb of frequency, because it shows that how often your father is late. So it answers how often, okay, that means adverb of frequency. Then next is he drove. Drove is the past tense of drive, driving a car or anything. So he drove dash to avoid being late, so here we can say he drove fast, okay, and fast adverb is the adverb of manner. How did he drive? It answers how, and that's why it is called the adverb of manner. And you can see in the next one, I dash play badminton with my sister, so we can say I regularly play, I everyday play, okay, I sometimes play. So again here adverb of frequency, because it answers how often. How often do you play badminton with your sister? So answer is regularly, every day, whatever you want to use, but it is adverb of frequency. The next is, this is the place where he fell dash. So here we can just use the adverb of time, okay, where he fell yesterday, where he fell 2 days ago, where he fell last month, okay. This way you can just write any word which shows the time, and into bracket you can mention it is adverb of time. Then next is, it took dash 2 hours to get here. So we can just use any word which shows the degree, okay, like it took almost 2 hours to get here. So means at what extent or at what level, at what degree we are just talking about this action. So we are using the word almost, and almost means it shows the degree. So this is what called adverb of degree. Then 12th is they were dash very friendly. So here it is a very simple sentence. You can simply use not, and it will be not will be the adverb of negation. Okay, because it is denial. It is a kind of a negativity. Okay, negative sentence. And he has dash strong hands. So here again we can use the emphatic word like very. He has very strong friends, and when we are using very, it shows degree. Okay, so again we have to write adverb of frequency in the bracket. And the last of this exercise is she has dash completed her degree course. So we can say she has definitely completed. Okay, she has certainly completed. Whatever you want to use, you can use. And they are showing some positive emphatic words. So you can say that this is the adverb of affirmation. All right. Now after this, you can see exercise C. Before solving this exercise, you need to understand what is adverbs of place. So as we can see that the words which shows some place, which tells us about some place, or the words which are used to tell something about place, they all are called the adverb of place. Like if we ask question with where, okay, and whatever words we get, they all are called the adverb of place. Here you can see the words like away, everywhere, here, there, nowhere, somewhere, okay. So these all are the words which we get in answer after we ask the question with where. Like where did you put my mobile? So you can say that I put your mobile here, I put your mobile there, okay. So that way all these adverbs are telling us about place, and that's why they are called adverb of place. And we can ask question to find adverb of place with where, where. So let's start with the exercise solution. Fill in the blanks with suitable adverb of place. So here also answer may be different. It's okay, but it should be meaningful. Fine. You have to use those words which can make the sentence meaningful. I am certain I left the books dash. So we can say where. So you can use any here, there. Okay. So I am certain I left the books here, or I left the books there. So you can say that this is the word which shows the place where I have left the book. So it is called adverb of place. The same way in the second one, she has studied art for 5 years. So where has she studied? So here means here in this university, in this college. Okay. Then I scattered the rose petals. Where did you scatter? So we can say everywhere. Okay. And Fluffy, my cat, played. Where did your cat Fluffy play? So you can say here, there. Okay. And my mother sings loudly. Where does mother sing loudly? So you can say everywhere, or you can say nowhere. No, let us use only everywhere. Okay. So you can just use the word as per the sentence which can make it meaningful. And then next is the children were flying kites. So where were they flying kites? So you can say here means on this terrace or at this place. So here or there you can use. So this also shows that at which place did the children were flying kites, where were the children flying kites. So the answer is here. So that is giving us the information about place, and that's why here or there is called the adverb of place. The next is seventh, Susan parked her bike. Again, we can say here or there. Okay, where did she park? So here or there. Then the little lamb followed Mary everywhere, right? You must have learned the poem when you were in the junior, senior. Mary had a little lamb. Okay, so in that poem, we know that Mary's lamb used to follow her wherever she goes, even when she goes to school. The little lamb used to follow her to the school as well. So we will use everywhere. Okay, where did the little lamb follow Mary? So everywhere. Then all the books fell. So where did all the books fall? So we can say here or there. and the last one is the army marched. How did the army march? Or you can say, you know, where did the army march? So we can say the army marched away. Let us use this one, as we have not used it any time. Okay, this one, away. So the army marched away. Fine. So this way, you need to understand that in all these fill in the blanks, we have used adverbs of place. When we ask question with where to the verb, we get the answer, and that answer is called the adverb of place. And now the last exercise of the video. Before we learn, you have to be clarified with the adverbs of frequency. So frequency means the, you know, the repetition of the action, or how often does the action take place. That is what called the frequency. So when you will ask question with how often, you will get the adverbs of frequency, like how often, so always, never, sometimes, usually, rarely, occasionally, normally, this, that. So these all words are called the adverbs of frequency, as they are just telling us the frequency of that action, like how many times it was repeated, how often does this action take place. So these all words can be used as the adverbs of frequency. But yes, don't get confused in between adverb of frequency and adverb of time. When we ask adverb of time, at that time we have to use question when instead of how often. Okay, we have to ask with question when. And when we will ask question with when, whatever we will get an answer, that would be called as the adverb of time. Here in these three sentences, you can see that we reached the venue at 7 p.m. So if we ask question with when do you reach the venue? So the answer is 7. So here the 7 p.m. answer is in the is the answer of the question when. Okay, so the same way, Rani came home today. So when did Rani come home? So we can say today. So again we have asked question with when. Varun will have for London. So here one word is missing, I think, left. We can add left. Varun will have left for London next month. So when will Varun have left for London? So we can say next month. So all these three, 7 p.m. today, next month, all these three words are answering us when we are asking the question with when. And the above given three examples are the answers of the question how often. Like how often John how often does John play, help anyone? So we can say never. Grandfather always prefers to go for a morning walk. So how often does grandfather prefer? So always. My mother wakes up at 5 a.m. every day. So how often does mother wake up at 5 a.m.? So every day. So how often? Never. How often? Always. How often? Every day. Okay. And when? 7 p.m. When? Today. When? Next month. So this is the difference between adverb of frequency and adverb of time. Adverb of frequency answers how often, and adverb of time answers question when. Alright, now let us start the exercise. In the very first sentence, here also we have to use the suitable adverb of frequency. Frequency, okay. The weather is dash influenced by the tropical jet stream. So you must have learned the geography. So according to that knowledge, you can say that weather is always influenced by the tropical jet stream. Okay, so always is the word which shows the frequency. Okay, and how often it is influenced. So always, frequency is 100%. So we have used always adverb frequency. Then next is employees are paid. You can write weekly, daily, monthly, yearly. Okay, quarterly, any word showing frequency can be used here. Then we can see each other dash on weekends. So we see each other sometimes on weekends. Let's say, so we see each other. We can use we see each other sometimes on weekends. Okay, how often do you see each other? So we can say sometimes, rarely. Then I have dash met him before. So you can say I have never met him before. Okay, How often have you met? So never. Tom Dash gets up before 7. So how often does Tom get up before 7? So we can use always. You can use sometimes, never, rarely. Okay. And have you Dash been to New York? So have you never been to New York? Or have you ever been to New York? Any you can use because it is a question mark. It's a interrogative sentence. So in that you can even ask question. Or you can just make it interrogative by using never also. Okay, and then she goes to the temple. So going to temple is good thing. So let us use every day. So how often does she go to temple? So every day. Then I dash think about becoming a pilot. So I always think about becoming a pilot. Okay, how often do you think? Answer is always. Then this is a proverb. Barking dogs dash bite. So barking dogs seldom bite. It's a proverb. Okay, very well known. You can even use never. Like Hindi mein kehte na jo bhokte wo kaatte, bhokte kutte kaatte nahi hai, garajte wo barajte nahi hai. So it is the English version for that. Barking dogs seldom bite, or you can even write never bite, because both are showing frequency. And the last one is Lena is dash allowed to stay up late. So Lena is it up to you, whatever you want to use. Lena is never allowed, Lena is always allowed, Lena is sometimes allowed to stay up late. Okay, so these all are the adverbs of frequency, which shows us that how often does the particular action repeat. Okay, so I hope you must have understood, and in the next video we will cover up the remaining part of the chapter and exercises. Till then, I want you to write all the exercises in your grammar magic. Do mention the kind of adverbs wherever needed or wherever instructed. Okay, thank you so much.